Hello and welcome back to Chem Help ASAP. As we talk about acid-base chemistry, we're actually performing a chemical reaction. So let's use this acid-base reaction, with which we're fairly familiar, to learn about how we draw mechanisms in organic chemistry. So we have at the top of the screen, we have two reactions shown. At the very top, we just show atom-wise what happens. But I've redrawn the reaction below it. With everything has full Lewis structures. So if you notice what happens, we are moving this hydrogen from whatever A is, and we're moving that hydrogen to this oxygen. How do we show this in a reaction? We're going to show this using what they call curved arrow notation. Sometimes people call this curly arrow notation. I think most people call it curved arrow notation. So, curved arrow notation indicates the movement of electrons. It's very tempting to say, oh, this hydrogen goes somewhere else. No, we're moving the electrons. So, we need to account for making this new OH bond. We start with the electrons, this lone pair of electrons on oxygen, goes to that hydrogen, so we start the arrow where the electrons are, we move to where the electrons go, which is to the hydrogen, and as a result, we're going to break this HA bond, and we have to track where those electrons go. Those electrons go to whatever A is. So if you look at our products, they reflect that. We have A that has an extra lone pair that we didn't start with, henceforth it has a negative charge, and this oxygen in our water, in our base, now has a new bond. This bonding pair came from, was formerly the lone pair that was on oxygen. And we've tracked all of this. The hydrogen is no longer attached to the A group, but it's attached to the oxygen instead. So this is curved arrow notation. As we get into more elaborate reactions, we'll use this notation, this curved arrow notation, to show how electrons move. Being able to draw mechanisms is a very important skill in organic chemistry, and while it may be difficult to follow in this first example, we'll see lots more examples and you get lots more practice, so hopefully it becomes kind of a second nature for you.